This video series covers the use of the Mauve Whole Genome Aligner in Geneious Prime. In this first video, you will learn to perform a basic alignment of complete bacterial genomes. Mauve is developed and maintained by Aaron Darling at the University of Technology, Sydney. The program is designed for constructing multiple genome alignments in the presence of large-scale evolutionary events, such as rearrangement and inversion. For further information about Mauve, including a full user guide, please see the Mauve website. This analysis uses the free Mauve plugin available from the plugins menu in Genius. In this exercise, we will create an alignment of three mycobacterium genomes. Holding down Shift, select the three sequence documents. These are complete genomes downloaded from NCBI. Then, go to Align, Assemble, Align Whole Genomes. Ensure the Mauve Genome tab is selected, and the algorithm is set to Progressive Mauve. All other settings should be kept at the default settings. For a full description of the parameters, see the Darling Lab website. Click OK to run the alignment. Note, in this example, we are using complete genomes where each genome is a single contiguous sequence. To align draft genomes, please see our video on aligning draft genomes with the Mauve Contig Mover. The alignment may take a while to run. Mauve alignments have a special viewer that enables you to see genome rearrangements and locally aligned blocks at a glance. Each sequence is represented by one horizontal panel of blocks. Each colored block represents a region of sequence that aligns to part of another genome and is presumably homologous and free from internal rearrangements. These are called locally collinear blocks, or LCBs. The colored blocks in each genome are connected by vertical lines. In this example, you can see there are three LCBs denoted by the different colors. In the middle LCB, the block in sequence NC_012943 is below the line. This indicates that this region is inverted with respect to the other two sequences. The Mauve viewer has its own controls for zooming in and out and scrolling to the left and right above the viewer. Try zooming in by clicking the Zoom In button 3 or 4 times. If your input sequence contained CDS, tRNA, rRNA, or misRNA annotations, these should become visible as square blocks below the colored LCB block. As you mouse over the colored blocks on any sequence in the alignment, you will see rectangular boxes showing the aligned region in the other sequences. You can click on the alignment to center it on any given region. To reset the alignment view at any time, click the Home button. The LCB weight slider has the effect of changing the resolution at which local collinear blocks are determined. The LCB weight sets the minimum number of matching nucleotides for a collinear region to be considered as having true homology, rather than random similarity. When Automatically Calculate the Minimum LCB Score is checked in the Mauve Setup options, an LCB weight of 3 times the seed size will be used for the alignment, and this will be set as the lowest value in the LCB weight slider. Try sliding the LCB weight up and see what effect it has on the LCB blocks. To view the aligned sequences in a view that looks similar to the regular Genius Alignment Viewer, click the Alignment View tab above the Sequence Viewer. This displays the alignment for one LCB at a time. To choose which LCB to display, use the drop-down Alignment Chooser in the Display tab next to the viewer. Try changing the alignment view to LCB2. This is the middle block where the NC_012943 was inverted. Check the arrow directions on the source annotations in this view, and you will see that NC_012943 is in the opposite orientation to the other two sequences in the alignment. If you cannot see the blue source annotations, make sure the annotation type Source is checked in the Annotations and Tracks panel. This alignment view works the same way as the regular Genius Alignment Viewer and has the same controls for zooming, sequence display, and annotations. However, only annotations can be edited in this viewer, not the sequence itself. If you wish to edit the sequence, you must create an editable copy, which will be a standard Genius Alignment document. You will be prompted to do this if you click Allow Editing. Now that we have covered how to align whole genomes using Mauve, we invite you to check out the next video in the series, where we will cover how to align draft genomes using the Mauve Contig Mover. Visit our Resource Center for more hands-on exercises and tutorials.